I've always wanted to bowl the boss of Google a googly. Let's see if we can stick a Google search on this.
More than what your mind says, you need to kind of figure out what your heart is excited by. And it's a journey, and you will know it when you find it. And if you find that, things tend to work out.
Sundar.
So good to see you.
It's very, very good to see you. How are you?
Let's get used to this new elbow bump.
Take one, Mark.
Historically, has Google paid enough tax in the right places?
We are one of the world's largest taxpayers. If you look at, on an average, over the past decade, we have paid over 20% in taxes. We do pay the majority of our share of taxes in the US, where we originate and where our products are developed. I think there are good conversations, and we support the global OECD conversations, figuring out what is the right way to allocate taxes. And, you know, this is beyond a single company to solve.
People always want to know about the personal technology habits of those who run big technology firms. Do you let your children go on YouTube? You've got two teenagers, I understand.
Yeah, I do.
What's your policy on screen time for kids?
I think this generation needs to learn to adapt to technology. It's going to be a big part of their life. So I've encouraged them to develop boundaries on their own, but you know, I've approached it as a journey of personal responsibility.
Because a lot of people worry that dependency on technology is destroying kids' creativity and really inhibits their ability to build relationships in the world.
Look, I think we should worry, and I think, you know, I'm glad there are experts looking at areas like mental health and all that. But I would also say that, you know, throughout history, we've always been worried about technology.
Okay. I'm going to end with some quick-fire questions. These are vaguely fun. Is your Google Home speaker always switched on at home?
Yeah, it is, yeah. But, it only listens when I address it, so I know that.
How often do you change your passwords?
I would encourage everyone, I use two-factor authentication, and, you know, I make sure. So I don't need to change my passwords that often because I have multiple protections in place.
How many phones do you have? I imagine you have 20.
It's more that now that I have as many phones as I'm constantly changing and trying out every new phone, and I'm testing it out all the time.
Are you Indian or American?
Well, I'm an American citizen, but I've India is deeply within me, and so it's a big part of who I am.
Favorite sportsman?
Well, I would say, since you're a cricket fan, Tendulkar, Sachin Tendulkar.
More so than Sunil Gavaskar?
Now you're making it very difficult for me.
Dickens or Shakespeare?
Dickens.
Dickens? Larry or Sergey?
Larry and Sergey, as I always say.
Do you eat meat?
I don't.
Republican or Democrat?
I keep my politics to myself.
How often do you speak to Mark Zuckerberg?
You know, as and when, there's no periodicity to it, as and when needed.
Jeff Bezos is going into space, would you?
Well, I'm jealous a bit. I would love to look at Earth from space.
When did you last cry?
Seeing the morgue trucks parked around the world through COVID and seeing what's happened in India.
My final question. What advice would you give to someone from humble beginnings who wants to run a great company?
I've always felt you just need to, more than what your mind says, you need to kind of figure out what your heart is excited by. And it's a journey, and you will know it when you find it. And if you find that, things tend to work out.
You wanted to be a cricket player when you grew up. And that makes two of us. So I have brought my lucky charm, so we could just have a little knock somewhere around here if you've got time.
Well, why not?
Let's do it.
I'm glad I caught that ball.
He can bat. Can you bowl? I won't hear that at your face.